Good morning. Today with us, we have Ragdev, who is the founder of ChatGenie, one of the EmergeX winners from the Philippines as a part of the Highway to 100 Unicorns program. Ragdev, you know, I'm so happy to have you here. My name is Latika Pai, and I head Microsoft for the VC and private equity partnerships in India. And I'm so thrilled to hear about your journey and what ChatGenie does. So Ragdev, from, you know, reading about your bio, you've done some really, really interesting stuff, right? Uber for dentist appointments. And so it'd be great to understand your journey and where you are right now with ChatGenie and how you, you know, came about, you know, realizing that a product like ChatGenie is something that businesses are looking for.
First of all, Latika, thanks for having me. It's a privilege to be in this interview. So we started ChatGenie as a chatbot product. You know, 2017 is really the peak of the hype of chatbots by Facebook. So we basically ran it for a year, and we saw a trend from our current merchants' usage. So basically, to summarize it, they don't like the chatbot experience. So the promise of chatbot is to offer a frictionless sales channel for their business. But in the end, the incorrect responses of chatbot are not really helpful to them. So we pivoted to AI approach to a more UI or transactional approach. We saw a trend in China wherein WeChat is dominating the e-commerce space. And the way how they do sales channel approach is they use the same transactional via UI inside their platform. So we figured, since that WeChat is not big in the Philippines, what if we do the same approach but inside Messenger? So that's how we came up with the current version of ChatGenie.
And is this bilingual or right now in English only?
So currently it's in English only. So, you know, Philippines is a market wherein there are a lot of English-speaking Filipinos. And hopefully, you know, we can market it in markets wherein, you know, English is also one of the standard language.
The segment that you sell to, who are your customers today?
Currently, majority of our customers are in the food and beverage space. So these are businesses that, you know, they find it hard to get onboarded on food delivery apps. So a good alternative is us, wherein they can accept orders online. At the same time, it won't break their bank because we don't charge commission or referral rate fees.
And what has been your go-to-market strategy so far? How are you looking at getting more customers to adopt your platform?
So we've been operating for less than a year now, and based from the data that we got, the merchants that keep on using our platform happen to be in a food and beverage space. So our go-to-market is to target those merchants that can't sell on Lazada or Shopee simply because they're selling perishable goods. You know, they need to deliver their goods today because if they can't, you know, their product will spoil.
From the world, you know, from the merchants who are using your product, Ragdev, what do you believe? You know, you just mentioned that they're working with perishables, and clearly, so this is a very important economic decision for them, right? To be able to sell the products, you know, in the time frame that they have for them to remain fresh. But more importantly, what have you seen as the lever to adopt technology, right? Because many of them are a little hesitant to adopt technology. So what has been that lever? Has that been because of COVID? You know, people are more open to adopting technology. So I'm just curious about that.
Sad to say, this pandemic crisis helped us in kickstarting our merchant onboarding process. So all of a sudden, when the government declared a lockdown last year, merchants cannot rely on their offline stores anymore. So they need to find a way to sell online quickly without breaking their bank. So that's a good motivation, and those parameters was satisfied by using ChatGenie. And also the way how merchants deliver to their customers right now. So when they receive an order, they use Grab app to deliver to their customers. So it's a very menial process for us. So what we did is we integrated this express delivery platforms on our solution. So when they confirm an order, the delivery booking will be sent to the express delivery platforms automatically. So it's like running an automated online delivery service without breaking their back. Basically, our solution is free.
Wow. But when you say it's free, how do you monetize it? I mean, I'm sure you're not doing this for charity, right?
Yeah, I know you're going to ask that. So we have a pre-tier subscription wherein we don't charge merchants, but we add 10 pesos, 20 cents USD for each of every successful conversion. And then additional 20 cents for each of every delivery. So when Grab or our express delivery partners provide us a quote of the delivery fee, so we just top up an additional 20 cents.
I think that's very fair. So basically, it's like a handling fee, you know, that you're charging for successful conversions, right? So I think that's a very interesting model. You know what you have just built, and I'm assuming that your market right now is for the Philippines. I think there is a global opportunity here, and so what are your plans for that, right? Because you know you have a product, anyone anywhere in the world can use it. So what are your plans and thoughts? You know, as being part of the Highway to 100 Unicorns, we really want to be able to help you scale fast and accelerate that growth. So what do you see as the opportunity here, Ragde?
So as you can see, we learned a lot from last year, from our operations, from onboarding, you know, this express delivery partners into eventually integrating them. So we have this workflow already. And it happened that our partners here in the Philippines have strong presence in the region, such as Grab, Lalamove, Mr. Speedy. So it's a matter of us localizing the product and then turning on, you know, our solution to those markets, such as Indonesia, Malaysia, Vietnam, Thailand, and eventually in India. And also the same trend that we are seeing, we can apply it in bigger markets such as North America. You know, in the U.S., they have Postmates, wherein it acts as same as Grab Express, our local partner here, you know, integrate on our platform and it can work as the same. Anyways, I forgot to mention our overall conversion rate for our sales channel is 15%. So that's 5%, five times better than other sales channels in the market.
Wow, that is fascinating. So clearly, you have, you know, you're seeing the opportunity in Philippines, and now you know through your partners, and you have some really good, strong partners in Philippines, and I do like your strategy that you know they are there across the region. So you would want to kind of piggyback on what they're doing in the region. From what I understand and what I just heard you say, you're looking at growing within the Asia Pac region and then potentially going global, right? From a Microsoft perspective, what is the support you're looking for? How can we help you? And what do you find most exciting about being part of the Highway to 100 Unicorns program?
I have to mention that recently we had a tech deep dive with one of the Microsoft tech consultants, and I appreciate all the things that you guys recommended to us. I think those same advice are the things that we need to go global. So they mentioned a lot how to scale with Azure platform. So that one important factor is a very helpful in this program, and also at the same time, I hope that you know this program can allow us to connect to local players in the region.
Sure. No, that's absolutely why we're here. I think what we are really looking forward to is working closely with you, Ragday, with your team, helping you both from a technology perspective, a go-to-market perspective, and getting you to scale. I'm very excited to see that, you know, in less than a year, the kind of traction that you've made, you know, for the product and the ideas that you have in terms of being able to take it, you know, across the region and globally. Good luck, and thank you so much for being here today, and we look forward to working closely with you.
Thanks, Lita.
Okay, great. Cheers.
Thanks. Okay, cheers.
Bye.
Okay.